Hi everyone, my name is Ryan Boyd, and I believe it's such an exciting time to be software engineers. The pace of technology development is astounding, and Neo4j and graph applications have advanced a lot over the last year. More and more developers are recognizing that a relationship-first data approach is important in modern application development. They're finding that graph databases form the foundation to this approach, providing both the necessary scale and performance, plus an intuitive and flexible data model that's easy to maintain. Now we're so happy today to announce the launch of the next generation of Neo4j, Neo4j 3.0. This is the first in a series of 3.x releases based on a completely redesigned architecture. This release demonstrates our commitment to offering the world's most scalable graph database, providing greater developer productivity, and an easy and flexible deployment model. Now let's talk about the key features of 3.0. First, we've completely re-engineered our storage layer to provide support for giant graphs with practically no upper bounds. This new storage layer, included in the Neo4j Enterprise Edition, enables developing graphs thousands of times larger than even today's largest graph. It is based on dynamic pointer compression, which preserves index-free adjacency while keeping the advantages of fixed-size pointers. And as a bonus, the new storage layer can reduce store sizes to increase efficiency on smaller memory machines. Now we've also re-engineered our index subsystem to effectively remove all indexing limits, while also upgrading to Lucene 5, taking advantage of parallelism, making index population faster. These re-engineering efforts will provide greater scale for your graphs today, while also advancing the architectural support for new features in future releases. We continue to improve Cypher, our declarative query language optimized for graphs. This includes additional indexing improvements for faster full-text queries, including the ends-with and contains operators. Now with the release of 2.2, we introduced a cost-based query planner to improve performance of read queries. We've now extended this support to mixed read-write operations, using statistics of your graph to determine the smartest way to work with your data. These same statistics are also useful to return some types of aggregation queries nearly instantaneously instead of scanning the full graph. We can now even relate two nodes via indexes of common property values. In addition to supporting larger graphs and faster query results, we also focused in this release on making it faster and easier for you to build high-scale graph applications. 3.0 includes Bolt, a new binary protocol for accessing the graph. This protocol is lightweight and efficient, plus provides a new graph type system. This enables type safety and uniformity across the stack, from language to driver to protocol to cipher to the database engine. You are dealing with the same data type. Now, what's uniformity in the protocol without support for the most popular languages? Well, we're also releasing new official drivers in JavaScript, Java, .NET, and Python, based on the Bolt binary protocol. These drivers are fully supported by our customer success and engineering teams to ensure they stay up to date and consistent with each other and with new releases of the database. Additionally, these drivers will form the foundation of richer idiomatic drivers and framework integrations to be built on top of them by our vibrant community ecosystem. In 3.0, we're also evolving what was previously known as unmanaged extensions into Java stored procedures and making them first-class citizens within the Neo4j database. Java stored procedures are custom code written in any JVM language and deployed on the server, and they can be invoked directly from Cypher. Now, as developers build and maintain graph applications, they often use the Neo4j browser, which provides web-based access to Neo4j data, complete with graph visualizations. Today, we're announcing Neo4j Browser Sync, which enables synchronizing saved scripts, settings, and graph style sheets across connections. This will improve productivity by enabling developers to effortlessly move between browsers and computers. Developers can also eliminate creating another account by securely signing into this service with their GitHub account. This release also includes an important change to improve deployment, configuration, and operations. We've completely re-architected the file structure of the Neo4j release. The new structure aligns the configuration and logging with how software is being packaged and deployed today. We now have a single configuration file and the ability to configure alternate locations on disk for most components in the Neo4j distribution. Every aspect of the Neo4j architecture has been revisited to make graph application development productive and intuitive. while at the same time supporting massive graphs. Download Neo4j 3.0 today to see the new storage engine, a new binary protocol, official drivers in many languages, Neo4j browser sync, and more. We hope you enjoy this release, and feel free to ask any questions that you have on Stack Overflow. We're here listening. Thanks very much.